new research happens at the intersection of different disciplines, and we're working at the intersection of biological research and astronomical research, developing new technology that will open up new doors into that interdisciplinary corner. After I understood how astronomers were applying adaptive optics for astronomical imaging, I thought that adaptive optics could be reapplied for biological imaging to enable deeper imaging in tissue at higher resolution. With biological imaging, you're trying to image through tissue rather than the Earth's atmosphere. The tissue distorts the image. Astronomers were using something called a guide star as a reference beacon for modifying the image. And so the idea there is if there's a galaxy you want to look at, and there's a star next to it, use that star as your reference and correct that star, and then the galaxy that comes through the same part of the atmosphere gets the same correction and that image gets cleared up. In biology, we didn't have guide stars like they have in astronomy. But in astronomy, when there's not a star next to the, say, the galaxy they want to look at, what they do is they project a laser up from the dome of the telescope, and about 100 kilometers up, there's a thin layer of sodium atoms. So you get what they call an artificial guide star, a little glowing spot about 100 kilometers up. In biology, they use fluorescent proteins that come from things like jellyfish. You can incorporate the fluorescent protein in different parts of the cell, so if you can breed it into the part of the cell that you want to look at, then you have a built-in guide star, fluorescent guide star. We have the leading researchers in adaptive optics here, people like Claire Max and Don Gable, and we've been able to benefit from the knowledge that they have from developing adaptive optics for astronomy, for biological imaging. That couldn't really happen anywhere else except for UC Santa Cruz.